go.
G'day, Bruce. G'day, Sheila. I'm Steve Irwin, and some of your good cunt mates from old England land want to make you a little video to wish you a bloody bonza wedding, mate. So we're going to go on a bit of a tour of Chorlton in the local area, have some look at the little critters from around this way, and yeah, hopefully it'll be a good one. Hey, cunt.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh, g'day Bruce, g'day Sheila. We find ourselves in Chorlton at the moment, just looking for some little critters about. Let's see what we can find. Yeah. Oh shit, what's that? Look at that! Oh fucking hell, mate! Oh fucking hell! We've got ourselves here. This little critter is known as the Great Breasted Greenwood. Also locally known as the Chorlton Booby. Let's see her in a natural. She's got the biggest bucket in town. Let's watch her in a natural environment trying to collect some money. This aggressive display is how they go about finding food and funds for their lifestyle.
Put it in my bucket! Put it in my bucket! Now!
Things are getting out of hand. We better go. Let's go. Let's split. Go, go, go.
Oh, look at
him. Dance on the fire. I'm parched as. Want a chop, bro?
Oh, don't eat chips, mate. I only eat plankton.
Plankton, bro.
Oh, plankton, bro. Oh, it's deceptive as, mate. Sweet as, bro.
Just shut your bloody mouth for 1 minute, will you, woman? Oh, good day, Bruce. Good day, Sheila. Today we have found ourselves a couple of little lesser spotted beavers. These beavers are particularly unusual because they like to hang out in trees. If we look over here, you can just about see them rustling. And if we listen real carefully, you'll be able to hear their distinctive call.
Love Patrol! Love Patrol!
So normally around this time of day, they start collecting wood. This is for their fire or for whatever else they're going to use it for.
Love Patrol! Love Patrol!
This behaviour normally goes on for hours and hours and hours. We're just going to stand here and watch it for a little bit longer.
Love Patrol!
Now, I don't normally do this, but these fellas can be quite aggressive, so I'm just going to jam my finger up his bum.
Love Patrol!
Hello, Sean. What are you up to, mate?
Oh, hey, I'm just measuring my dick. You see, 66 inches.
Oh, 66 inches, eh?
That's a pretty impressive dick.
Oh, that's sweet as, bro.
On the street, we have a competition amongst everyone's dicks. There's a few different categories.
Oh,
length, girth, general appearance. Later, I'm going to give my dick a good scrub.
Oh, yeah?
But when it gets wet, my dick gets real slippery. So I'm going to have to put a caution sign up on it. I don't want anyone getting hurt on my dick. And later, when I've finished measuring my dick, I'm gonna polish my helmet.
Oh, shit, bro.
Oi, get that squirrel off my dick. He's not allowed to come on my dick.
G'day, Sheila. So today we're in a little lesser known spot of Chorlton. This is known as Langenith. So here we are, I found ourselves a little specimen. Look at this little beauty. She looks like a frisky one, I'm gonna jump on her. You gotta be real careful, you approach slowly from the back. First thing I'm going for is her head. Right, watch this, ready. Go! Ah, gotcha! Ah, gotcha, see? So, the first thing you gotta do is secure the head. Oh fuck, she's fighting like a right little cunt, eh? Oh man, oh shit, let's get... Oh fuck! Oh, whoa, fuck, no! Oh no! She's getting away! Fuck, let's go! Oh, come back here, you little shit! Oh, you little shit! Get back here! Oh fuck! She's pinned out now, she's not going anywhere, right? So you can see from the Gordon's alligator, they've got these big green eyes. Lovely little specimen, this one. Look at the size, look at the size of her posterior as well, and she's got a lovely tail.
Table 66, two paninis and a hamburger.
Normally around this kind of time of day, they start collecting wood for their little fire.
The fuck do you want?
Come back! One thing this little critter's well known for is the depth of the bush.
You start dancing on fire and then I'm coming down.
Oh my god!
They guess going to Australia, they love the word. They use it as punctuation.
Let me get this. Hi guys! Greetings from London. I've just come down the old Appleton Pears, picked up the dog and bound to send you well wishes on your wedding day. Hope you had to have a fantastic day. So, so sorry that I can't be there. It would be fabulous to share this day with you. Sam, I can't believe you're getting married to a girl. Katie, I'm so happy for you. You're gonna have a brilliant life together. And when you look into each other's eyes, I hope you realize you're now looking at the person who is statistically most likely to murder you. I hope you have a brilliant future together. All the best, guys. Hopefully see you soon.
Hey, Sam. Congratulations on your wedding day. I hope you have an amazing time with your new bride, Katie. Look after Liz. Make sure she doesn't get kidnapped by anyone who thinks she's a hobbit, though, eh? Thanks.
Hi, Morris. Phoebe and I just wanted to say congratulations on your big day. Hope you and Sam are very happy, have an amazing day and a very amazing future together. Bye.
Here you go.
Hello, Sam and Katie, congratulations on your wedding. I'm so happy for you guys and I'm really touched that you invited me. I was really pleased to come along. So, you know, massive congratulations again and good luck and best of everything for your life together. Also, Mr. Shark says the same thing, which he's lost his voice, otherwise he'd say it. And yeah, that's it from me, really. Massively happy for you. The final thing is to apologise for everything that I did at the wedding reception.
Hey guys, hello Sam, and of course the future Mrs. Jennings. I hope you guys are both well. This is just a brief message to wish you all the best on your big day. Massive congratulations. Sam, you're a top bloke. I really enjoyed getting to know you when you were over here in the UK. I'm sure you're going to make a fantastic husband. So yeah, seriously guys, have a blast, enjoy your day, and all the best. Many happy returns. Laters.
Hi guys, we want to send you a very cheesy message.
You must be over the moon.
We hope it was a damn good day.
Katie, I know we haven't met you yet, but rumour has it Sam thinks you are the cheese knees.
And we're sure that you have a great future together.
Which just keeps getting fetter and fetter.
With each other by your side, you'll cheddar be alone.
Anyway, we gotta go.
And I'm sure you can't bear any more.
And to be fair, We're clutching at cheese straws.
From ours to eternity.
Cheese! Cheese!
Hi Sam, hi Katie. Just wanted to wish you an amazing wedding day. We're really gutted that we can't be there with you to spend it.
Yeah, hopefully our antics will go viral and we'll be internet billionaires before too long.
We're really gutted, especially to be missing out on Trevor's wedding speech, which I'm sure will contain some inappropriate jokes.
Yeah, hopefully it'll be a colourful one. Eh?
Have an awesome day. We miss you guys and we hope to see you here or over there soon.
Take care.
Let's go!